This is how you perform the Escom Floppy Fix on an Amiga 1200 motherboard. First of all, take your Escom motherboard and put it upside down on your workbench. Be sure to work in an ESD safe environment. Okay, now let's zoom in a little bit onto the internal floppy disk drive connector. There we go. Do you see this orange colored wire? That wire is bad news. It will interfere with the signals going between the floppy disk drive and the floppy disk drive controller on the motherboard. So if you have that wire on your motherboard, you will have to remove it. I will not go into the technical details here and explain why you need to remove this wire and talk about the ready signal, the disk change signal and all that stuff. I will leave that for another video. Next, take a small signal wire of some sort and solder it in place like this, like I have done with the green wire here. Now of course, before you solder that wire in there, you can always check these 2 points for continuity. If you already get continuity, you don't need to put that wire in there. But if you don't measure any continuity between those 2 points, your motherboard is in the need for an Escom floppy fix, and you will have to solder the wire in there, just as shown here. And if you don't have much experience in soldering, just be careful, okay? Try to use a temperature-controlled soldering station, and never apply your soldering iron for any longer than 2.5 or 3 seconds or so to any pad on the motherboard, and I'm sure you will be just fine. Okay, that's it. Now you can once again hook up an Amiga-compatible shugart floppy disk drive to your motherboard and enjoy all those track-loaded games. Have fun!